Okay, let's talk about basic algebra. And in algebra, one of the things that you do, especially when you first start learning algebra, is evaluate expressions. So what we want to do in this particular video is evaluate this expression for these values. Now, I'm going to kind of keep things vague here because I want to give you a full opportunity to solve this problem all on your own. Now, if you could do this, go ahead and put your final answer into the comment section. I'm going to actually show you the correct answer in just one moment, and then I'm going to tell you what evaluate means in algebra, and then we're going to walk through this problem step by step. But before we get going, let me quickly introduce myself. My name is John. I'm the founder of TC Math Academy. I'm also a middle and high school math teacher. I have been teaching math for decades. It really is my true passion to help as many people as I possibly can learn mathematics. And I'm going to tell you right now, all of you could be successful in math. And I'm especially speaking to those of you that have a tough time with math. Please do not give up hope. Not only is there hope for you to pass your class, if you happen to be taking a math class, you can excel in math. And you may not believe that, but here's what you need. You need great math instruction. In other words, whoever you're learning math from or whatever you're learning math from, you have to understand nothing's more frustrating than being in a classroom and being in a constant state of confusion because you have not learned anything. Okay, now math is a technical subject. And, you know, it can be confusing. But the way I like to teach math is to explain things in easy to understand language so everybody gets what's going on without watering down what you need to know. So if you need help in your current math course or maybe some sort of special test that you're getting ready for that has math on it, things like the SAT, ACT, maybe the GED or teacher certification exam, or if you're homeschooling mathematics, check out my math help program. I'm going to leave a link to it in the description of this video. I literally have over 100 plus different math courses that span these categories and much, much more. I'm also going to leave links to my math notes in the description as well. It is critical that you have a great pair of notes. You should be taking your own notes. Now, if you're not, you need to start taking better notes immediately. Okay, note taking is critical to be successful in math, but you can use my notes in the meantime if you like. And if this video helps you out, don't forget to like and subscribe, as this definitely helps me out. Okay, so let's go ahead and show you the answer. Then, of course, I'm going to explain to you what evaluate means in algebra. But here we have 4xyz plus 6 times x minus z and parentheses divided by y. And of course, we have our values down here. What is this equal to? Well, the answer is 92. Okay, so how did you do? Well, if you got this right, and by the way, if you got this right and you use a calculator, that's perfectly fine as well. As long as you got it right, that's what counts. But let's go ahead and celebrate your correctness with a nice happy face and an A plus, a 100%, and multiple stars so you can tell your friends and family that you know how to evaluate an algebraic expression. I'm pretty sure they're going to be very impressed. They're going to be like, wow, that's awesome. Anyways, let's go ahead and get into what this means, evaluate, okay? Because this is a verb, okay? We're being told to take some action here. You're going to see this word continuously in mathematics, okay? Especially in basic algebra, i.e. courses like Pre-Algebra, Algebra 1, but this is a skill that you'll always have to do no matter what level of math you're in terms of any math course beyond Pre-Algebra, okay? All right, so evaluate. What does it mean? Well, effectively, it means replace these respective variables, okay, with the values assigned. Now, let me explain it to you another way. Here we have an expression, right? Now, this is not an equation, because we don't have an equal sign, right? So if I had an equal sign and I had some number, this would be an algebraic equation because, again, I have an equal sign. So I don't have an equal sign here. So I'm just expressing something. This would be like a sentence, right? I'm just saying something here algebraically. And I have these variables, x, y, z. I have x here, z here, and y there. But what do these variables represent? Well, they represent nothing more than numbers, okay? That's the main idea in algebra. Variables are nothing more than numbers. They represent a number with a particular value, okay? Now, what we can do is assign a specific numeric value for these variables, i.e., we can say, oh, we got x, we have y, we have z. Let's let x equal to 2, let's let y equal to 3, and let's z equal to 4. if we give these variables, we assign these variables a specific numeric value, well, then we can now evaluate, which means we're going to plug in into these respective variables that we're dealing with the numbers that we have right here, and then we're going to simplify the remaining numeric expression. So we're going to go from an algebraic expression into a numeric expression. Then we're going to have to apply all that good stuff that we learned way back in middle school, things like the order of operations, positive and negative numbers, etc., etc. Okay, so that's all this is. So step number one is to replace the respective variables with the values assigned. So let's just make sure that no one is lost here. We'll take this one at a time. So here we have 4 times x. So x is equal to 2. So we're going to replace that x with a 2. Okay, so we have that right there. And you can see that I did this in a nice color-coded kind of way. So you go, hopefully, you know, this is extra clear. Then y is what? Well, that y is 3. So we have a 3 right there. And this is all multiplication in algebra. When you have variables written next to one another like this, x, y, z, this means multiplication, x times y times z. So z is 4, so we have a 4 right there. So this is going to be 4 times 2 times 3 times 4 plus 6 times what? Well, this is going to be parentheses. This is very important. You got to keep the parentheses. X is 2 minus z. Z again is 4. And parentheses divided by y, and y is 3. So we'll put our 3 right there. Okay, now one of the things that you want to get in the habit of when you're evaluating algebraic expressions, is once you've plugged in your values, double check that you didn't make any mistakes. Okay, I've seen this so many times throughout the decades where students, they'll basically do the right problem. From this point forward, they'll have everything. They plugged in some values, and then they got the right answer. Here's the only problem. They plugged in the wrong values. They made a mistake, but they did all the math right. So it was like a big, a big bummer. I was like, oh man, look at that. You could have had 100% on your test. You could have had an A+. And then you'll get these kind of expressions like this. You're like, what are you talking about? Cut me some slack, Mr. Math Teacher. Listen, I'm telling you right now, always, always double check. But anyways, so with that being said, now let's go ahead and do this math right now. All right, so here, this is all multiplication, and then we have parentheses. Again, we're going to have to keep the order of operations in mind. So that is PEMDAS. Let me go and write this up here, PEMDAS. So order of operations, please excuse my dear Aunt Sally. P is parentheses. So you're going to have to do what's inside parentheses here. And then E is exponents or powers, which we don't have any. And then we have multiplication and division. But this is a separate number, okay, from this expression right here. Okay, now, so if this kind of confuses you, you need to work on the order of operations, but I can go ahead and just simplify this right here. So we could take at least 2 steps, not kind of break this down into 1 step at a time, although that is kind of the preferred way you should do things. But we can go ahead and just get this right now. So this would be 4 times 2 times 3 times 4, that's 96 plus 6 times, I have to focus on what's inside the parentheses here. So 2 minus 4 is what? That's going to be negative 2. So I have 96 plus 6 times negative 2 divided by 3. All right, so hopefully that makes sense to you. So what do I have to do next? Well, again, PEMDAS, right? I'm thinking PEMDAS. Is there anything more left to do inside parentheses? No, okay. Are there any powers? No. So I'm focusing on multiplication and division from whatever I see first from left to right. So what do I see first here? Well, I have 6 times 2. This is multiplication. This is division. So I'm going to do the multiplication next. So 6 times negative 2 gives me negative 12 divided by 3, right? So you're going to go ahead and take 1 step, write the answer to that. So I have negative 12 divided by 3. So do I have any more multiplication? No, but I have to move on to division. That's what I have next. And so let's go ahead and do that right now. So negative 12 divided by 3 is going to be negative 4. Okay, of course, I have positive 96 plus a negative 4, or 96 minus 4 is a positive 92. Okay, so again, evaluating algebraic expressions are really taking a algebraic, expression, something like this, plugging, you're replacing the variables with specific numbers, and then this just becomes one big order of operations problem. And if you're taking a course like Pre-Algebra, Algebra 1, you're going to be doing a ton of problems like this. So you need to know what this word means, obviously, but even more importantly, you need to know how to set these problems up correctly, i.e. when you plug in the values for the respective variables, double check and make sure you have everything set up correctly. And then you have to just no more than two steps when you're doing your work, your order of operations work, to simplify and get your final answer. All right, so if you need help, additional help with evaluating algebraic expressions, I'm gonna recommend that you check out my pre-algebra course. I also have additional videos on my YouTube channel that can help you out. But if this little video helped you out in some small way, don't forget to like and subscribe. And with that being said, I definitely wish you all the best in your mathematics adventures. Thank you for your time and have a great day.